questions that you have.
Okay, we're in. Hello, good afternoon again. This is Conexión MSX, your podcast about MSX in English and also Spanish. Here we have the administrator of Russian Beer Software Corporation. Right?
Not really. Like it's not corporation yet, but it's just a crew, Russian Beer Service Crew.
Okay. Explain us. You've got some new material. This meeting, not exactly new material, but new firmware for your Carnival, right?
Yeah, that's correct. We are currently working on the new firmware that actually has new features. For example, we have this dual slot setup where you can select games for slot one and for slot two and launch them together. For example, Game Master plus some other games. Then we have some additional features in the boot block, which is our start menu. And these features will be like a full dual reset when the cartridge will be properly initialized after power up. And then we'll have some small additional convenience features, like for example a fixed frequency set on boot.
Uh-huh. So you continue, Carnival 3 is going to happen?
Probably not.
You will continue evolving Carnivore 2.
Well, the thing is, after I saw Flashjacks, uh-huh, I realized we can't jump over that thing, and it's so let's say full of features that we can never dream of creating something like that, I'm afraid.
Wow, that's a great thing. That's really saying a lot. Flashjacks was really impressive on its own, but coming from you, this is really, really, this will really mean a lot to the developer of Flashjacks.
Yeah, I talked to him. Like, I really like how the cartridge was designed, how it was implemented, and it has basically everything that Carnivore has, but four times.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think it's. It's way too much for a cartridge, but if a person implemented it and it works properly, it's really cool. Mm-hmm. And I really hope to have it someday, maybe.
Yes, I would. It would be great if he decided to come here and to show up and to explain his hardware to the people and so on. But I hope that one day he changes his mind.
Yeah, we're currently like working on the new firmware, and we don't plan to drop the support of Carnivore 2. Mm-hmm. So there will be new features coming. We have a sort of a backlog. Like, you can create a ticket for us, for example, for a new feature in Carnivore or for a bug in Carnivore at GitHub.
Uh-huh.
And we will try to fix the problem or implement a new feature. Uh-huh. If you need it.
And show us, you have wrote something with you.
Yeah, I actually I got a lot of questions from people asking why Carnivore 2 is Carnivore 2, why the number 2? Well, that's because of this. This is Carnivore 1. This exists only 10 copies in the entire world, or maybe even less now. We first implemented this cartridge as basically a flash ROM cartridge plus SCC. There's uh-huh. nothing else. There is no IDE, no FMPEG, no RAM. So it's just a simple multi-mapper cartridge.
Pretty much a prototype of what Carnivore 2 would become.
Yeah. Actually, Carnivore 2 got much of these design ideas, and the boot block was also, which we made for Carnivore 1, it was then ported to Carnivore 2 and much improved. This cartridge has a big Altera Max chip, and it is so complicated to solder it, and it's so big and expensive, so it's no point to have this chip just in one small cartridge. Now you can do small Altera Max, and it will do everything that this cartridge makes.
Okay, I see. Also, you have brought a lot of other things. Are you doing new developments right now? or you are concentrated on Carnivore 2?
Currently we are concentrated on Carnivore 2 because we need to release the new firmware, the new boot block, the new utilities, and we are currently working on the C2Love, which is a file manager for Carnivore. So you'll have like Norton Commander style file manager, and on one plane, like one plane on the right will be Carnivore, and on the other plane it will be your disk drive. So you can just copy files from N2 Carnivore, copy configuration entries and so on.
And what about you? Last year you told me about project you had for a diagnose cartridge. For diagnosing problems in an MSX.
Oh yes, we started working on this project, but our developer already bought some parts and prepared a prototype board. But we still need to put a lot of effort into even designing this thing from scratch, because we don't have a prototype. We have ideas how to do it, what we want to have as visualization. For example, there are some cartridges that just show you blinking LEDs instead of signals, but that is not right. You need to measure the frequency. You need to see if the bit is stuck or unstuck. And it should be not visible on the MSX screen. It should be visible on its own screen. That's why we wanted to have a bigger screen, maybe something mounted on top of the cartridge. But as I said, we have a lot of ideas, but implementation will take maybe months, if not years.
Yeah. I was aware of this last year when you told me. I was like amazed. It's like a portable bus corner line slider.
Yeah.
It tells you, okay, well, your problem is like this. You need to change memory. You need to your problem is CPU, is power supply. That would be
correct. The problem with this design is that it has to be a machine in its own. So it has to be everything inside this cartridge. It has to run independently from MSX. So which means it has to have its own RAM, its own ROM, its own circuits to measure the signals, frequency, and maybe some connectivity. If you, for example, want to test the video output, it has to be a special input for the audio and for the video, so that the cartridge recognizes that it's something is wrong with it, it's missing or it's distorted, the frequencies don't match and so on. So it's a very challenging project and we hope to complete it someday, but currently, as I said, we are fixed on making Carnivore better with the current design, because Carnivore 3 is not likely to happen. I think there is no need for it after FlashJacks.
Well, the problem is that FlashJax is also difficult to produce.
Well, this was also difficult to produce, and Carnivore 2, original one, it took me 12 hours to solder. But everything can be, with certain help and with certain technologies, it can be made easier and cheaper. I hope FlashJax finds out how to make this cartridge as to the production.
Okay. Okay, thank you very much. I don't know if you have, because I have something else to ask you, because your mind appears to work faster than mine, and maybe you are already have a prototype of something there, and I have not noticed at all.
The new thing that we made lately was upgrading one of these Russian computers, MSX 2 model YIS 805 to MSX 2 Plus. So this machine exists only one. There is only one machine in the world like that, because Yamaha never released MSX 2 Plus. So we made a special video board for it, similar to what we made for other Yamahas, and of course we made some adjustments to the machine to relocate, for example, the CPU, because the CPU was under the power supply. And we had to relocate it in order to be able to put the FM pack into it.
Yeah. It does not look like the best place to have the CPU, I guess.
Exactly. Well, I mean, it's under the power supply and there is like this gap for it. But when you put another board and a Z80 on top, it touches the power supply unit. It's not a good thing.
Okay. Then thank you very much for your time.
One more thing. We now have a website. The website is rbsc.su, SU is Soviet Union domain, so we decided, as we are all, we're all born in the Soviet Union, so we decided to buy this domain, rbsc.su. So on this site there are there is information about our current projects, about our future projects, about the group itself, and links to all repositories and documentation, as well as the licensing information. If someone wants to license our cartridges for, let's say, selling their games in shops or prototyping, then we can negotiate.
Okay. Thank you very much for your time. Спасибо.
Thanks a lot.
Okay.
It was good to meet you.
Thank you. Okay.